Last election saw the emergence of so-called freedom parties in New Zealand. None of them reached the 5% MMP threshold. But ahead of next year's election, several parties have been proposing they join forces. Ahead of a high-profile protest at Parliament this week, Whena Owen spoke with some of the party leaders.
Down in Bar Africa on Wednesday night, it's Albany's turn for the Democracy NZ Roadshow with leader Matt King.
This guy thought he was coming to see Mike King.
Yeah, I thought he was going to be funny.
He genuinely thought that this was Mike King on tonight.
Matt King, the former National MP for Northland, launched his party soon after visiting the occupation at Parliament. That seems to have paid off.
So why have you come here tonight?
Because I seen Matt at the peaceful protest.
Are you looking for a party to vote for?
Definitely looking for a party to vote for, so I like to, Matt's not the only one that I'm looking at.
I was actually a member of the National Party, but I haven't renewed my subscription.
So you're looking around, you're what it is.
Matt King claims that 20 to 30% of voters are what he describes as politically homeless.
I've never seen anything like it. I mean, I think this election's going to be the most important election that this country's ever had.
This is where I work and have worked basically the last 30 years, 5 days a week at the coal front. And I see all the problems with young people and the people here every day.
South Auckland barrister Ted Johnston is co-leader of New Conservative, along with former teacher, now law student, Helen Harton.
Well, family, of course, is who we are, is the heart of New Conservative.
New Conservative was founded by Colin Craig. Last election under Leighton Baker, they gained 1.5% of the vote. Since MMP was introduced in the mid-90s, no new party has broken through that 5%.
All of the smaller parties recognise that, and we know that very likely we will need to make deals, make coalitions, make alliances of some sort. So we, like every other party, no doubt, is having meetings, informal meetings with everyone else.
Since I've been here, I've been doing a lot of meetings around the community.
The Outdoors and Freedom Party was given a boost at the Tauranga by-election, controversial lawyer and anti-vaxxer and co-leader Sue Gray, gaining just under 5% of the vote.
Really, really fun place.
She's in the UK right now, but still on the campaign trail.
We will be the game changers in Parliament. There's scope to have some sort of alliance or umbrella party that represents a whole range of different issues, and we can actually disagree.
But you want to be that umbrella party?
I want to be part of that party. I don't necessarily think it has to be the Outdoors and Freedom Party. We're well placed because we're registered.
Vision New Zealand is registering at about one for the first time. That's Hannah Tamaki's party.
The poll was a very pleasant, beautiful surprise. And I think it puts it down to the fact that people have got to know us a little bit better over the lockdowns and over all that's been happening, and maybe visually seeing me at protests.
At their last protest, led by Brian Tamaki's Freedom and Rights Coalition, Tamaki announced he was establishing an umbrella party and that four minor parties had signed up.
Can you yet name these other four parties that you're talking to?
You know very well the answer to that. No, I can't.
Somebody thought this jug was worth like hundreds of dollars. Go to Briscoe's.
Back in the Tamaki's kitchen, we pressed Vision NZ's leader on those parties.
It's not my place to say to in front of the camera who the other people are. They have to actually be prepared themselves to say it. But from what I'm understanding, Brian wants to announce it on the 23rd, on the steps of Parliament.
Brian Tamaki has said that he reckons he has four parties signed up.
Oh gosh, that's interesting.
He hasn't told us about that, but no, we have had informal discussions.
No, it's certainly not us.
We need to move away from this co-governance and biculturalism and get back to what New Zealand was built on.
Echoing Hobson's pledge and well over on the right, the New Nation Party is off to Tamaki's protest on Tuesday. Its leader, Michael Jacob, told Q&A, after Tuesday, things will get interesting.
There is no alliance at this stage that we're involved in. We are talking.
One party is a Christian party who won't say who they're talking to. It stood 29 candidates in the last election and is led by Ian Johnson, who cites lessons from the past.
Jim Anderton proved that It can be done by bringing minor parties together. The problem with the alliance, we believe, was that Jim took over and actually overwhelmed the minor parties and their voice.
Thank you so much for coming along tonight.
Matt King's Democracy NZ also made it to the latest poll at 1%.
So at the moment, you haven't signed on to an umbrella party arrangement?
No, I haven't, and I don't think we will be. I'm confident that Democracy NZ, our strategy and our team, we're willing to give it our best shot, and I absolutely believe that the fact that I could win my seat gives me an advantage over all the other minor parties.
So only one of the parties we've looked at may possibly have a deal with the Tamakis. That's New Nation Party. But in the age of Facebook, right-wing local freedom movements, some with political ambition, are constantly popping up.
Enough is enough!
It was also a 23rd of August, 18 years ago, that Brian Tamaki led his last big protest to Parliament. This time, he plans a people's court.
We don't want people to get hurt like they did at the last one.
So I guess people in Wellington are wondering, will they put tents up? Are they going to try for another kind of...
That's not what it's planned for.
But there could be somebody out of your control,
Once we all walk away, Brian and Freedom and Rights Coalition and the Freedom Movement walk away, whatever anybody else does, sorry about it. Not our concern.
The idea of People's Court and the Nuremberg Trials and Code is often talked about by the freedom movement. This weekend, the outdoors and Freedom Party leader is off to Germany.
There's some kind of commemoration of Nuremberg this weekend, I believe, so I'm doing my best to get there.
Back at Bar Africa, Matt King's audience are on their feet. He knows he has many more anthems to sing if Democracy NZ is to go it alone.